today is really exciting.
You know, this gives me incredible hope.
It's called the Zero Childhood Cancer Precision Medicine Program. And before now, they focused on helping the sickest Aussie kids with a less than 30% chance of survival. Now, thanks to a $67 million funding injection from the federal government and the Mindaroo Foundation, the program is being expanded to all children aged 18 and under for all types of cancers.
A true team effort with all 9 of Australia's children's hospitals participating, as well as 22 national and international partners. There is nothing like this on this scale anywhere in the world.
Cancer kills 3 children every week in Australia, but this promising new approach is expected to prolong the lives of more than 1,000 children a year.
The platform analyses every single gene, 22,000 genes.
The program uses sophisticated analysis of a patient's genomes, scanning for unique genetic alterations that might be driving a cancer's growth. If found, doctors can then prescribe drugs that specifically targets their cancer,
giving the promise of improved treatments and lower likelihood of short and long-term side effects.
The first clinical trials in 2017 identified a treatment recommendation in more than 70% of cases.
And we were actually staggered by the results. Of the children who had received their recommended personalised treatment, 70% of them either had a complete remission, a partial remission, or their tumour growth was stabilised.
Ka-ili Giteau-Tai was just 4 years old when she was diagnosed with a rare form of kidney cancer that eventually spread to her lungs. After Zero's genetic scanning, medicines were developed that enabled her to make a full recovery, and now she's in remission.
When families hear about this, what they say to me is it gives them hope, it gives them a belief.
We're joined now by Ka-ili Giteau-Tai, recipient of the Zero treatment you saw in that story, and her mother, Kristy Giteau. Kristy, when you first got Ka-ili's diagnosis, did you ever think you would get to this point?
Definitely not. As an oncology parent, it's sort of a day-by-day process, and I remember first getting the news that Ka-ili had cancer in 2019, and yeah, it was hard news to take. We hadn't had cancer in our families and we didn't know what that journey was going to look like. Fast forward a year to 2020, we relapse and we're having similar conversations about her life expectancy and treatments that we'll take. And then the program was presented to us, and as a parent, you just want them to sort of be able to go to school and do everyday things. So for us, it was a no-brainer. We jumped on this trial.
Ka-ili, how old are you now?
Big 7-year-old, aren't you?
Oh.
Yes.
Oh, that's just so gorgeous. We love this. Kristy, this was a treatment for the sickest of sick kids. Were there any hesitations about undertaking the Zero treatment to begin with?
Yeah, there was some pretty stern conversations with the head of the program, Professor Glenn Marshall. He was fortunately our oncologist, and he sort of didn't dress things down. He gave us some pretty harsh realities. I suppose the side effects were unknown, being a trailblazer in this program. There were lots of unknowns, but what he did tell me is he gave me confidence that we should just go ahead. And I think as an oncology parent, you make so many tough decisions that when it came to this and we'd come to this crossroad, for me, I knew in my stomach it was the right decision to make.
Well, Kristy, what was the treatment like in this program? Because you hear kids having cancer leads to chemotherapy, they can get quite sick. How was Ka-ili throughout the whole process?
Yeah, well, I mean, like any oncology journey, we had ups and downs and there were good days and bad days, but on a whole, she bounced back pretty well. And the beauty of this program was it was personalised to her genetic cancer. Upon relapse, they did a biopsy and they knew that there were different treatments that we weren't using that we should explore. And as a result, her recovery was quicker. The results that she was in remission came quicker. And for us, it was the right decision.
Ka-ili, you're looking amazing, but what I really want to know more than anything is who is better at touch footy, you or your sister?
Definitely me, of course.
Yeah. What makes you better?
Do you score lots of tries?
Yeah, score more tries than her.
Yeah, well, that'll do it. That's pure stats right there. You can't argue with those numbers. What's it like to have so many friends now you've come out of hospital?
It's great, just because I get to play with them on the monkey bus and, yeah.
And run past them and score more tries, obviously, as well.
High five them in the end.
You started up a charity fundraiser celebrating bravery. Who do you think is the bravest person you know?
Mommy.
Oh, why do you say that?
Just because she made the charity.
And so it's so funny she says me because she's by far the bravest that we know. And she actually mentioned her friend Sophia was also one of her bravest people. Why was it Sophia?
Just because she was helping me on while we were in hospital.
What kind of things did you do to help each other, Ka-ili?
She was making me she was making me not lonely in hospital.
That is such an important job. How wonderful. And I'm sure you kept her company too. Kristy, you, of course, would have been keeping lots of other parents company in that oncology ward too. Just how exciting is this breakthrough, this news, for you, hearing that other kids across Australia with this god-awful disease might be getting help?
I'm excited. To make this a national rollout and for every parent to have the option, not just our high-risk kids like Ka-ili, but everyone that presents with cancer to have the option to either go forth with this treatment or to fall back on the normal generalised protocols. But having that choice is huge, and I'm really excited to see in what direction it goes and to see more kids in remission like my daughter, Ka-ili.
So, Ka-ili, this has been a huge success for you. You've got your whole life ahead of you. What's the thing that you're really excited about getting stuck into?
If you could do anything right now, what would you want to be doing? Now that you don't have to go to hospital all the time, what's the thing that you would love to do straight away?
I would like to help people.
Oh, that's nice. And maybe wash it down with an ice cream or something.
Yeah. Sure? Well, Kristy, Ka-ili, congratulations. Thanks so much for joining us tonight. And Ka-ili, you're such a great little kid. We can tell everything you've been through and the person you obviously already are, extraordinary. So it's great to be able to speak to you.
Thanks for having us.
Well, sorry. By the way, a big question that arises out of this is, could this be used for adults? Mm. And they really trial this in kids because you have to start somewhere. But we did ask Professor David Ziegler from the Children's Cancer Institute about this, and he says, if we're able to streamline this and prove its utility and the feasibility of doing this in children, if we can prove that, there's absolutely every reason it could then be expanded to adults with cancer as well. So there's nothing about the science, it seems, that's about kids. Wow. And imagine what that breakthrough could mean.
Amazing.
If this became available for everyone.
Incredible. Yeah.